Yeah, thank you very much. We are here today to come
social
and
distancing.
Stand our ground. We are maintaining social distancing here as well. But today we want to clarify some issues that is ongoing on the social media. Please, all the activists that are here today, we are not sponsored. So we want to clarify this. We are not sponsored activists. Yes, we are here for good governance of Nigeria.
Yes.
That is why we are here. We are not here as APC or PDP member. No, some people came here as a PDP member or as an activist, but they only did about 3 minutes or 5 minutes video and they left. So which type of activists are they? They did the same thing on the second and today again, only spent about 5-10 minutes and they left. Those people are not activists. They could be sponsored. They could be politically motivated. We are not politically motivated. We have been here for 2-3 hours now. Those are the people that have the love of Nigeria in their heart. And that is why we are here today.
Yes.
And why are we here? Some people say, we have where to go. Does it make sense? Okay, let us quickly point it to you. Let us look at the constitution of Nigeria. Despite the fact that some people condemn, criticize the 1999 constitution, That is flawed.
Yeah.
Okay, which I agree is a flawed constitution, and does not meet the quorum because it was made under the junta revolution without involving other states. But however, there are still some clauses there that are still vital. For example, let us look at section 14(2)(b) of the 1999 constitution. What does it say? It states clearly that the welfare and the security of the citizens shall be paramount to the government of Nigeria. The question now is does the government protect us? The answer is no.
No.
Let us look at the definition of government according to the 1999 Constitution, Section 3181. It says that the government include the local government, the state government, the federal government, and all governmental agencies. So, like the Nigerian Police and DSS, which I will take an example here. Now, the question now is: in 2013 and 14, PMB himself he campaigned against poor health care in Nigeria under Goodluck Jonathan, which is reasonable as well. And he promised that if he becomes a president, he's going to give us good health care in Nigeria and ensure
it's
that security are maintained for us.
Yeah.
That was his promise.
Lord,
now, for example, let us look at on the 8th of September 2016, President Muhammadu Buhari launched Change Begin With Me with two vital consents that we should patronize all made goods and services. The question now is to fellow Nigerians that are listening to me, on what class can you put the state government hospital and private hospital? That could be classified as a patronizing state services. So the question now is, has Buhari patronized that?
Now, before I go further,
we have Aso Rock Clinic, isn't it?
Yes.
Do you know the budget of Aso Rock Clinic?
Somebody who has not prayed.
So the question now is, what is the purpose of Aso Rock Clinic? I'm asking the fellow Nigerian.
You know what it means to be a doctor.
Huh? Now, since 2015 to date, the question now is, BNB have traveled out of Nigeria on medical, not on other businesses, not on for treaties, on medical 12 times out of Nigeria. Does it make sense?
No.
No.
Number one. Number two, Aisha Buhari got neck injury, ordinary neck injury, that's supposed to be treated in Aso Rock. She flew to
Dubai.
Does that make sense?
No.
Number three, his son got accident. He was flown to Germany to go and treat. Then what is the purpose of Aso Rock budget? What is the purpose of hospital? What is the purpose of private hospital in Nigeria? So we have a lot of problems that we need to solve in Nigeria. And that is why we are here to advocate for good governance. So we are not being sponsored by anybody. That is what we are saying. Those are our ground that we want good governance in Nigeria. For example, when according to Dr. John Apple, the health economist in the health, he said that to build hospital could cost about 7 million naira, 7 million pounds.
Wow.
For example, he said that clearly. That's Professor John Apple of Health Economics in Northfield Hospital in Bristol. He said clearly about 7 million can build mental health hospital. In Nigeria, the only mental health hospital you have which I know very well is in Yaba. The whole of Lagos State. That's craziness.
Yaba left.
And another one in Abeokuta, Aro. Does that make sense?
No.
This shows that the government have not put the citizens at heart. Now, let me go further. Let
like
me go further.
Years.
Let me go further. According to research, to build a national average hospital in Nigeria, it could cost about 112.5 million, which we can afford. Average hospital would cost about 60 to 187 million, which we can afford. Minimum hospital would cost about 52.2 million, which we can afford. The maximum hospital with about 200 or 300 hospitals will cost about 210 million. Now, the question now is, according to the post from Bristol Hospital, the Northfield Health Hospital in Bristol, how massive it is, it costs 32.7 million pounds. In Nigeria today, one of our politicians can afford this is in the bank account.
Okay. Sure.
Number two, St. James Institute, the oncology in Leeds that treated cancer, it was built, but with 4.9 million plus another 1.4 million, making about 6.3 million to build this. So we can afford those money. Now, there's one hospital in Turkish, according to Dr. Mustafa Hansen. He said this hospital, the Nazi hospital in Turkish, with 80 beds, it was built in 2014 with how much? $20 million. $20 million is what some of our politicians give to their girlfriend for shopping.
Sure.
I must be honest with you. So the government doesn't have us at
heart.
That is why we are here today, to advocate for good governance. Mm-hmm. Let me carry you along, please. According to one of our research, to build primary healthcare hospital in Nigeria, which is from local government, with about 20 to 30 beds, it can build it for 25 million naira.
Yeah.
Which local government can afford? Do they do it? No.
No.
Primary healthcare again, with about 50 to 60 beds, it can be built with about 50 million naira, all inclusive, very good one. They don't have it because they don't have what has had. And this is our own fault as well. As the citizens, the power belongs to we, the citizens.
Sure.
That's what we're trying to let people know that the politicians are our messengers and we need to enforce them. When we kept quiet, that means we are consented to their corruption. That's why we are today. We are not anti-PMB. We are not anti-APC, but we are anti-poor governance.
Sure.
And that is why we are here today. So we are not enemy to Buhari, as some people may think. No. Listen to all our grants. Then you can justify us.
He's our enemy.
Okay. Now, let us look at...
He is.
Let us look at one point.
And
he stands back in what is innocent people get killed.
Yes.
He says nothing. Yes, let us look at one point, ladies and gentlemen. According to SB Morgan, Lagos Bay Intelligence Department, he said that between 2011 June to 2020 March, you know, the government of Nigeria, they had the bad government. Governance of habit of paying bandits.
Imagine.
So from 2011, June 2011 to March 2020, he stated that these SB Morgan's, Lagos based intelligence department, stated that between 2011 to 2020, the Nigerian government have paid $18.34 million to bandits. The question is, do we need to pamper the bandits?
No.
No,
I know.
Now, in conclusion, I would try to look at the convicted politicians in Nigeria. I'm only going to point about two or three convicted politicians. We know that this man has been convicted. The ex-governor of Bayelsa State, he has been convicted with $55 million. That $55 million can build a hospital in Nigeria. As I said, let's say $20 million to build standard hospital for us. So we can build about three different standard hospitals in Nigeria. So we are here to advocate that
proper hospital
for governance to cease in Nigeria.
I think we can.